Wright, the founder of Project Confetti Kids, and I wanted to talk about staying on track when you are teaching from home. Sometimes it can be very difficult because you're in your home environment and it's just so easy to get off track. It's like, oh, well, here's the TV, or there's your favorite reading corner. So it's like, oh, we'll do it tomorrow. But here's just a couple of tips on how to stay on track. So first, I would create a schedule for yourself, and don't make the schedule so grandiose that you can't stick to it. So if you write down, like, on Mondays we're gonna work for 6 hours, like, that might be hard to stick to. I would start small and then build from there. Say, okay, on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays we're gonna work for 2 hours, and then on Tuesdays and Thursdays we're gonna work for 1 hour, or whatever it is. So then that way it feels achievable. It's like, oh, I can do this. And don't even necessarily stick to, like, it has to be 2 hours sitting down, like 2 hours in one seat. It could be, okay, we're gonna work on this for an hour, and that hour is gonna consist of a 30-minute lesson, and then some independent work and some activities, and then we're gonna do something else. So you can break it up, because you also have to consider, if you're a stay-at-home mom or dad, you also have to go grocery shopping, take care of the house. So sometimes things could get off track. So just being realistic with yourself as to what you can keep up with, and creating that schedule, and don't make it too big for yourself. Also, have a basic theme for an entire month. It's like, okay, well, we're going to learn about dogs, and within that we're gonna do some reading about dogs, and you can incorporate all sorts of things, like science experiments, everything, because in that way it just kind of keeps you on track instead of waking up one day, it's like, okay, what are we doing today, kid? And then another thing that you can do is, I actually like workbooks for kids that they can do independently. And that's not by any means something that they should sit down and do all the time, but it could be something where sometimes kids just don't want to hear it one day. It's like, you know what, I'm tired of you yapping. And that's fine. Like, my kids get tired of me yapping all the time. It's like, okay, well, you can work in your workbook and work on any activity that you would like. And if you need help, let me know. And at least that way the kid has some say in what they work on that day. And that can be exciting for them. So that's what I would suggest. Just stay on track, create a schedule, nothing too bad that you can stick to, so you feel like you're progressing. Because there's nothing worse as a parent than feeling like you're failing your kids or you're ruining them. And I say that because, and I'm not saying anybody is, but we all feel that way. Like, I feel like I'm ruining my kids, or like I'm failing them. I already can think of, like, several things I could work on with my girls. I'm like, oh, I could do this, and this. Like, I'm ruining them. But don't feel that way. Just know it's a process. And I'm speaking to you and myself right now. But it is a process, and kids will get there. They're resilient, and they want to learn. They want to learn. So that's the tips that I have for you today. I hope you're having a great day, and I will see you tomorrow.